do that beat? Yeah, boy. Hi, sneakies. It's me, Fifi, and I'm back. I'm back again today with the reaction to a brand new group, brand new for me, not for you. Today, I'm going to be reacting to GWSM for the very first time. You guys are gonna have to tell me how to pronounce their name. And today I'm going to be reacting to their newest release, which is Like Hot. Then I'm gonna be reacting to Red Sun and Bazooka. Now, I have had a lot, and I mean a lot of requests to react to this group. This has been one of my most highly requested groups recently. So I'm assuming they make music that I would like. I know absolutely nothing about them whatsoever. But I'm excited since I've had so many requests. I'm sure they are good. Let's just go. Guys, quick disclaimer before we start. I do not like to react to captions on because I find captions distracting. I like to concentrate on the music. The music production is what I like to comment on the most. But when I'm looking at the words at the bottom of the screen, I'm not concentrating on the song and I'm missing parts of the MV. I will read the lyrics later in my own time. Let's go. Okay, so it says, Gongwonsanya. I'm not sure what Gongwon means, so okay, let's go. Like It Hot MV. Let's go.
Like It Hot.
I love that. Dun, 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 dun. Already.
Like It Hot.
noise, but someone is trimming hedges right now, so I hope it's not too disturbing for you. Please just try and ignore it. Guys, I'm really, really sorry. I'm trying to ignore it. I actually feel like crying right now. I'm so annoyed. I feel like crying because now is my only time to record this. I can't delay it for later and I can't concentrate. It's pissing me off. Okay, so the hedge trimming has stopped. Apologies if it did affect the while I was reacting to the MV. Hopefully it didn't though. I really, really do apologize for the noise. I absolutely love the song from the get-go, straight away. Those synthy sounds that you know that I love. I can see now why you guys were requesting for me to react to them so much. And this is just the first song. There were a lot of nice dreamy synths and pads. And I absolutely loved the melodies. You guys know I'm a sucker for melodies. If I like the melodies, I'm in. At some point, there was like a beat switch up. I loved that moment. The vocals were great as well. I could hear some really, really nice ad-libs. I have to be honest though, and this is funny because someone yesterday was like, you always say that you're hard to please when it comes to rapping and rap verses, but I never hear you critique any rapping when I do all the time, essentially. And I replied to the comment with lots of examples. But funnily enough, today is an example of that. Nothing to do with the rapper herself. More to do with, I feel like, I just didn't feel like it needed a rap verse. I feel like sometimes rap verses are forced into K-pop. She sounded good, but it kind of just took me out of the vibe that I was in. Also, I thought that I maybe heard her singing at some point. It would have been cool just to have her singing. Also, the rapper looks really cool. I like her. I might bias her already, even though I didn't think it needed a rap verse. I love the visuals as well, and there were some really, really quirky moments in the choreo. But yeah, let's go on to the next one. Okay, guys, so next up is the Red Sun MV. Let's go! I like that little intro. That's cute. Red Sun. I love that! fake every single time. Ooh. Whoa, the choreo, that was so cool. Yeah, you guys are gonna need to explain their storyline and everything as well. Ooh. What is occurring? Okay, so this one was a lot more housey and a lot more EDM-y. I loved it. The chorus was really, really interesting because there was parts that I really loved and then parts that might have to grow on me. Like, I absolutely loved the break. It's like a mini drop. I loved that part. But there was an EDM-y sound in there as well that I think will have to grow on me a little bit. It was super, super catchy though. Again, really, really nice synths and like really nice twinkly sounds. Their sound so far has been reminiscent of IZ*ONE's sound for me personally. I noticed they have really, really nice ad-libs and like harmonies and stuff going on in the back, which adds really, really nice layer to their songs. Makes it sound that little bit more dreamy all throughout, even though it's quite heavy like house influence. Also, the way they deliver those ad-libs and harmonies and vocals, really, really good singers. The rapping, I'm still not sure how I feel about it. Not the rappers themselves at all. I actually really like, I didn't know there was two. The first one that came in, the one that was rapping on the previous track, I actually really, really like her tone. I'm just not sure how I feel about the rap verses in this. Also, at some point she was sort of rap singing, so she was rapping with more of a melody and I felt like it just fit a little bit more. So interesting. We'll see. Let's go on to the next one. Okay, guys, so last but not least, we have Bazooka MV. Let's go! Miles. I thought it was going to say MILFs. Ooh. I'm loving those piano chords. It's giving me house influences again. Oh my gosh, she's so cool. I love that build up. Yeah. MV. They've started cutting hedges again. I really, 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 really apologise. There's no other time that I can record this. I'm already late to work. I really, really apologise. So we're gonna have to work through the noise. I really, really enjoyed that one as well. That was really, really nice. It had like a very new disco sound. That sound was around a lot in the UK in like the early 2000s with songs like, do you guys know a song called Lola's Theme? If you don't know that song, check it out. It was just a sound that was really, really popular then and it reminded me of it. A lot of people might hear this and think it's disco influence, but I think it's new disco influence. It's kind of like a combination of like disco and like house, sort of. Again, their vocals were on point. The little ad-libs and the melodies and the stuff going on in the back, I need you guys to listen and concentrate because those parts really make and fill their songs, and you guys know I'm a sucker for that. I love the visuals the most in this one as well, because I've said to you guys before, but I really, really love lighting in terms of visuals, and the way like the lighting and stuff was arranged on some of the scenes, loved it. Now, guys, I have to be honest, I'm always honest in my opinions. If you don't want to hear my opinion now, just click off if you can't handle just hearing honest opinions. I was not feeling the rap again. I felt it was out of place. There was no need. It didn't fit the vibe. I just didn't think it was needed to be there. I don't know if the rapper can sing. Obviously, if the rapper can't sing, then there kind of needs to be a rap verse in the songs, but I feel like all idol rappers can sing. So I don't know, I feel like it's just being forced in the songs. Obviously I'm gonna need to hear their B-sides and stuff to fully like come to a conclusion, because whenever I listen to Twice, I don't like the rap verses in the title tracks. I say it every single time. But now I've been listening to their B-sides, the rap verses actually slap and they really, really work. So that might be the case with them as well. I just don't feel like it needed a rap verse. It kind of took me out. I just wasn't feeling it. That's just me, guys. That's my opinion. But I did really love them. I did really love the songs. I will react to them again. Request 2 MVs and I'll be back with another reaction to them in maybe 2 or 3 weeks. And yeah, that's it, guys. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, subscribe if you haven't subscribed. If you have subscribed, I love you. Gonna follow me on Instagram, guys. Gonna follow me on Twitter. And yeah, goodbye.